Hey everybody, welcome to No Ideas Media. I'm Nick Syke, and I want you to see what comes up when you Google GMO food. I mean, there's lots of tomatoes in here, which is weird considering there are no GMO tomatoes, and there's, kiwi oranges, and just needles everywhere. Oh, and here's an article about glyphosate in Forbes with a picture of somebody with a backpack sprayer and a wand in an orchard. Oh, and another story about glyphosate in an agricultural context paired with a photo of consumer packaged Roundup. People, ag has an image problem, literally and figuratively. The images that get used to explain the science and technicality of farming, they are just so often wrong. So why are these images of agriculture incorrect, and how do we correct them? You ever heard that phrase, garbage in, garbage out? The idea that your finished product can only be as good as your raw ingredients. Keep that in mind here. Well, when somebody in the media like myself is looking for the perfect image to add to their work, there are really only a couple of ways to go about it. If you're small and you have no money, like me, you have to look for copyright-free images. Basically, pictures that other people have put somewhere on the internet and have made free for everyone to use. So, if I'm looking for, say, an image of GMO canola, I'd start by typing that into Google's image search, then choosing images that are labeled for reuse with modification. That means free to use. As you can see, that starts to limit my options pretty darn quickly. And while that's a limitation for small media outlets like myself, it's not really a problem for big media outlets. Like Forbes and Reuters, they'd be more likely to pay for the images they use. So over at stock image sites like Getty Images or Shutterstock, well-funded companies would work with those sites to find images in their archives that fit the desired project. Look, you can actually see it right here in this photo. Photo credit goes to Getty. Now, obviously the editor of this article searched agricultural workers and this image came up. As you can imagine, the images that you get out of Getty are only as good as the images somebody put into Getty. So, crappy free images of agriculture found through Google image search and crappy expensive images of agriculture found through stock sites like Getty. Those are the two ways that a person in media would access stock images. So, fixing farming's image problem could be as simple as making better images available. How would we do that? Well, I'm part of group number one, starving artists who can't always afford to pay for images. So, like when I'm Googling for copyright-free images of GMO food to use in my work, where is Google Googling those pictures from? Where do they actually come from? The fact is, there are a plethora of different websites you may or may not have heard of where people can upload pictures for other people to use and stuff. My personal favorite is a website called Pixabay. I'll show you how this all works right now. Check it out. So if I search GMO food in Google image search, this is what comes up. Now, I'm also gonna specify usage rights, and I'm gonna use labeled for reuse with modification. That essentially means copyright free, free for anybody to use. Now you can see that drastically reduces the number of available images that are there, but one of them is this syringe in the tomato image. Now if I click on that and follow it to the website that it came from, boom, it's coming from Pixabay. So this is the website that I was just talking about, Pixabay. I mean, basically some idiot photographer just grabbed some dish gloves and like an insulin needle and a tomato and made this image. And because it's free and available on Pixabay, it comes up in Google image search when you look for copyright-free images. And because there aren't a lot of images to use, this one gets used all the time. So here's the remedy to this. This is a photo that I took a while ago of GMO canola seed. This is Liberty Link. This is L252 for a variety. It's a good photo. It's an actual GMO crop. It's not fear-based, it's a thing. So I'm gonna show you how easy this would be to upload to Pixabay and just follow along. And pay attention because I'm gonna be asking you to do this too. Okay, so Pixabay home screen, gonna sign up here, gonna pick a username, gonna say no GMO, no GMO movie at gmail.com, and pick a password. Let's see if that works. Sign up. Thank you for signing up. We just sent a confirmation email. Okay. So there you go. It's as simple as that. You put in email address, password, username, and then you get a confirmation email. Boom, you've got a Pixabay platform, I guess, profile. You don't need to worry about any of the profile images or anything like that. Go right to the upload button. It's gonna ask you to check a couple boxes. I only upload images I own the rights to and not any purchased or copied images. I agree that my images are released to Pixabay under the Pixabay license. Fair enough, fair enough. And that's as simple as that. So now we're up in the upload section. I'm gonna select the file that I want to upload and it's uploading and it's uploaded. Okay, now it's asking me for tags for the image, right? So I'm going to type in GMO, comma, genetically modified. And here comes a bunch of other tags to use. Biotechnology, agriculture. Let's get into the actual details of it. This is Liberty Link. This is canola. And the most important part is this hashtag. Hashtag ag bio pics with an X. So GMO, genetically modified, biotechnology, agriculture, genetics, Liberty Link, canola, L252, ag bio pics. You know, that's looking pretty good. Let's save that. And there it is. Our image is now available on Pixabay, which means that our image is now available in Google Image Search. So anytime somebody searches the words GMO, biotechnology, canola, L252, Liberty Link, and then cross-references that with free to use images, this image should come up free to use. Now, give it a minute or two because this takes a while to get approved. They gotta, you know, confirm the image isn't bad or anything. So it takes a minute. It's pending right now, but pretty soon when you Google, this image is gonna come up. Okay, now for part two, those expensive pay-to-play image sites. What are we gonna do about those? Well, it's funny, you know, I was thinking about starting this project and I heard from the folks over at BioFortified that they were kind of having the exact same thought at the exact same time. So we've decided to kind of divide and conquer this a little bit. If you're in agriculture and you also consider yourself a shutterbug, then you might actually be better off just ignoring these free to use sites entirely. I mean, throw a few pictures up there, whatever, but really high quality, well-composed images would be better off serving like big media outlets like Forbes or Reuters. The trouble is that it takes a lot more effort and time to upload images to Getty. Like, you can't skip the profile portion of that, and there's a monetary aspect. It's more involved. But lucky for all of us, BioFortified has agreed to take care of the hard work here. In the description for this video, you'll find links. One will take you to a blog post that explains BioFortified's plan in more detail. The other link is a submission form. Again, if you consider yourself like a farm photographer, this is what you want to do. Submit your work through this form to BioFortified. That way, the next time a writer at Forbes goes hunting for an image of glyphosate application, maybe they'll actually find an accurate one. What a novel idea. So I'm pretty fired up about this idea. And I'll be coming back to this quite a bit over the summer, just bugging you all to keep at it, and maybe being more specific about what kinds of images are needed. But before we get into all that granular detail, let's just see if there's a will to do this at all. I hope there is. I hope you're willing to help. I think with a little bit of effort over this season, we could really make a big dent in agriculture's image problem. But in order to know that we've actually made a dent, you gotta do one thing. Remember to tag every single photo with the hashtag agbiopics. This is crucial. If we do that, we ought to be able to Google for that hashtag and count the number of photos that come up, giving us a rough idea of how big our dent actually is. Let's flood the internet with positive and accurate images of agriculture. Can you imagine Googling GMO and getting like well-labeled photos like this instead of crappy fear-mongering photos like this? It's a brave new world. I think we can all agree that's a change that would be awesome to see. So help make it happen. Stay tuned for more information in the coming months, and thanks for watching.